In other news, President Marcos has begun wooing Japanese business leaders to invest in the Philippines. Joyce Balancha now joins us live from Tokyo for more on the president's working visit in Japan. Joyce, over to you.
Carmina, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and some members of his business delegation engaged in a dinner meeting last night upon his arrival here in Tokyo, Japan for a five-day official working visit. The dinner meeting was hosted by Mitsui & Company and Metro Pacific Investments Corporation. In his message, the President stressed his intention to revitalize the Philippines' partnership with the Japanese companies. He said a lot of deals have been affected by the recent restrictions due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
The partnership between not only Mitsui but all of Japan and the Philippines has been a long-standing one. We can point to so many of the developments that happened in the Philippines with the assistance of the different Japanese funding agencies and government-to-government arrangements, commercial arrangements, and these have been to the benefit of both our countries.
With the President were First Lady Luis Araneta Marcos, former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, House Speaker Martin Romualdez, the CEO of the Mitsui & Company, Kenichi Honi, and some members of the business delegation. The Department of Foreign Affairs earlier said that an important part of the President's five-day official working visit is the series of meetings with potential investors. Officials from the Japanese Embassy earlier claimed that the Philippines remains attractive to Japanese businessmen due to the Marcos administration's economic growth projections. Many are also interested in the government's priority agenda related to information and communications, healthcare, and agriculture. Carmina, this morning, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. also had roundtable meetings with some Japanese businessmen engaged in the semiconductor, electronics, and wiring harness industries. And this afternoon, the main highlight of his schedule will be his audience with Emperor Naruhito and his wife and a separate summit meeting with Japan's Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Joyce Balancha there, joining us live from Japan. Back here in the newsroom, two more Japanese nationals detained at the Philippines Immigration Detention Facility were deported Wednesday night. The fugitives, Yuki Watanabe and Tomonobu Saito, are being linked to scams targeting the elderly in Japan. On Tuesday, their co-accused, Kyoto Imamura and Toshiya Fujita, were handed over to Japanese authorities. President Marcos says their deportation was requested by the Japanese government.
Well, it was actually in the process already before the Japan trip was even planned. Nagkataon lang na it was just by coincidence that it happened. Of course, I didn't hurt because it is a request. It was a request of the Japanese government, and so we were always going to acquiesce to that request. And we thought perhaps it would clear the decks, as it were, for the talks that we will have with the Japanese.
The Philippine Trade Department defends its decision to approve price increases for dozens of basic goods. The DTI says price adjustments had to be implemented due to soaring inflation. It adds the hikes went through a thorough study, balancing the interests of both manufacturers and consumers.
Consideration yan yung study namin ng presyo ng raw materials, imported or local, karamihan pa imported. Tapos yung consideration ng fuel prices, manufacturing cost nila, lahat na, halo-halo na. So, pinag-aralan mabuti, nakita nyo naman kung gaano rin katagal. Ibig sabihin, every now and then, nag-update kami para masigurado na pwede na ba, dapat na ba, para masigurado natin na magiging fair din naman sa consumer.
The Philippine Amalgamated Supermarkets Association also saying the price increases are necessary for manufacturers to sustain their operations.
Tatanggalin sila ng tao, hindi na nila kaya. Imbis na mag-expand sila ng negosyo, baka lumiit ang negosyo, mag-shrink ang buong economy if all the companies slowly shrink, di ba? Recession ang tawag yan. Lalong walang makain ng tao, lalong walang trabaho.
The Philippine Economic Zone Authority confident of achieving a 10% increase in investments this year. In 2022, PESA approved a total of 198 projects amounting to 150 billion pesos. But that's still below the 237 billion pesos worth of investments recorded pre-pandemic. PESA Deputy Director General Vivian Santos hopes they can get back on track as more eco-zones get approved.
Breakdown of this 29 with pending proclamation are 13 IT parks and centers, 12 manufacturing, 2 for tourism, 1 agro-industrial, and 1 mixed-use ecozones.